Gonna open our feet, hip width apart. Perfect. Right head, shoulders back against the wall. We'll get the weights in 1 minute. The warm-up's gonna be warrior one, warrior two, extended right angle and reverse. Right, so open your foot towards whatever, it's my right foot, right? Hips and shoulders, they square off, meaning they face the wall in front of you. And if you saw headlights, they'd be right in front of you. So if you're at a little bit of an angulation, the lights aren't right in front of you. So really rotate the back hip without tweaking the front knee. It's a little, you gotta really watch and feel, all right? And bend the front knee, all right? And still keep the hips squared off. Look down and make sure you can see your big toe on the inside. That's the alignment cue for warrior two. Open the arm. Open, look over the front shoulder. Warrior two and hold. 1-1002. Now swing your back arm around to warrior one and bring the back hip. You might have to adjust by lifting the back heel and just letting your hip rotate a little bit more and get your shoulders, hips face forward. The arms are up by your ears and breathe up. Now swing your arm, the inside arm, back and down and open to warrior two. There's a lot of good little rotation there. Perfect. You just fiddled your knee and corrected it, so self-correction. Take your right arm and bring it to the right knee. Don't let the hip break at the waist. Let your whole torso lengthen if possible and keep the weight on that back foot down. Reach away, breathe, look up under your arm. And then swing back up without changing the knee or the hip. Warrior two. And breathe in reverse. Breathe out. One, two. So now let's do it as a little more active flow. Go warrior two. One, two. Swing around. Warrior three. Breathe. Back. Warrior two. Extended right angle. You can drop your front arm if you want. Just watch that alignment. Keep your shoulders stacked in your hips. Aligned. No breaking. Come back. Warrior two. Warrior three, reverse, that's a lie. Reverse, warrior. Good. Nice. Come back center. Lift up on that heel. Rotate it forward, your front heel. And you're going to do a lateral squat side to side. So bend the right knee, send the hips back. You bring your hands to the ground, right? What I want is you to squat and try to keep that front heel flat. And if you throw your hip back, you'll find that. A lot of times you want to come forward. I don't want that. I want the heel back. I really want to get in your groin. Breathe in, come back up. Breathe out and go the other way. So send the hip back. It's more of a hinge. And only go as far as you can. Keep the heel flat. Bring your fingertips even all the way through. And you can let this front hip and this front toe roll up. So it's here. It's one. And breathe. Two. Drop, relax the groin. This is a hard one. Everybody wants to come on their tippy toe, but try to keep your butt back. And it could be this too, just to get that motion. Nice, breathe in. Look ahead, get a nice little flat back. Open your arms, airplane arms, and come up. Awesome, now lift my left leg. It's the opposite leg. Lift up on that heel, rotate in the hip. Drop that front foot, warrior two. So we'll do that flow, all of those, that whole thing we did on the first side three times. So it's warrior two. Swing around, breathe out. Keep the weight on the outside of that back foot, but get that hip. This back hip really work on getting it forward. But breathe and hold, warrior one. 1-1002, swing back and open, warrior two. Come to extended right angle. Drop your hip. Nice stretch. That should feel really good on the outside of the front leg and the back inside groin. Breathe in, come back, warrior two, and reverse right away. Breathe out. You can leave the front leg straight or bend. Come back, warrior two. And around to the front, warrior one. Breathe. Pull. Back, warrior two. There's a lot of hip work going on. Extended right angle. Breathe. And come back. Reverse, hip forward, shoulder back. Look down, or look up. Nice, one more, warrior two. Hold, two, warrior one. Breathe, one, two, warrior two. Breathe, hold. Extend the right angle, now you can go to the ground. Get that alignment, beautiful, drop that hip. And come back, reverse. Nice. Reach overhead. Now fly back forward and bring your arms down. Heel toe in a little bit. And let's do that power up push up that we did before. Just three of them, okay? So walk your hands out to down dog. And you go dive. It's a dive bomber. You come down, dive bomb, drop down to the ground, come up cobra. All the way back down. Push up to plank. Push back. Down dog. All right, that's it. Broken down. And breathe. And you just go one. Breathe. Go two. You drop all the way to the ground. Nice. Come back up. Just do one more. Three. Because I'm not being very successful at this whole back where you go back to hover and push up. So that's okay though. Nice. Breathe. Good. So come on your knees. Okay. Let's add a quick little weight. Now we can either do it with weights or without weights. It could be a body weight workout. I'm going to grab a 12 pounds because I have them. I didn't say that in the beginning. I'm going to bring the weights up on my shoulder. I'm going to step up with my left foot and my right. And then back with my left and my right. And then you can really play up and down. I think it makes it much harder. It's like doing Stairmaster right in your living room. Breathe, right? Feel it? Okay, just two more. Good. Nice. One. Breathe. Nice. Then we're going to stay down. Awesome. Woo! Good. Now let's go down and lay flat. All right, we're going to do, we're going to lay on the ground, we're going to do a chest press. Okay? We're going to do two weights together, and then we're going to go right, left, two, together for five times. Okay? So breathe out and lay on the ground and watch it out. I'm using 12-pound weights. Weights can face, they can face you or they can face away. All right? Your palms can face in or they can face away. So it's one. Sorry, I did one at a time first. One, and then two, squeeze, two, squeeze. So right, push, left. Now I want the wrist to stay over your elbows. I don't want the weights to compress into your chest. They stay out, push, breathe, push. There. Now my palms are facing away. The next one I'm going to rotate. I'm going to come up with both of them and rotate them in. Palms face. I'm going to punch with my right, my left. Then I'm going to do both. I think this is four. We have one more to do, right? Good. One more. It's good to throw weights in every now and again, especially in our upper body. Yeah, nice. Good. Now hold the weight overhead. Breathe. Bring them onto your hips, both of them. All right, and just because, walk your heels in as far as they can be. All right, and now we're gonna come up and we're gonna do a weighted bridge. All right, you're not arching though, you just come up so your hips are in line with your knees and the shoulders. And you hold this, go five, four, three, two, and one. And then now I want you to lower and pulse for 10. Down, nine, really squeeze in the hip thrust. Seven, six, feet stay flat. Five, four, three, and two, and one. Nice, awesome, good. Now just get the weights out of the way for 1 second. Awesome, all right, ready? So let's do a little of the Pilates abs. Extend your left leg out and take your right leg up in the air. Walk your hands and bring your nose up. Get to where you can feel your whole back on the ground. Lift the extended leg, it doesn't touch. So wherever you are the most comfortable, push yourself a little past it. Breathe, go. Squeeze your abs and breathe out. You're isometrically contracting your abs. So this is a whole body thing. We're gonna do this 5 times each side. You bring the nose, you pulse, you go. That's one. As fast as you can. 3, 4, 5. Then come up, bring your hands behind your head, bend the knees. We're going to do a Pilates bicycle. We don't pedal, we kick and push. So it's you extend one leg and rotate your whole body. Left elbow, right knee, your right shoulder drops. Come back in and go the other way. It's slow. Come in. So 1, 2, 3, 4. You don't have to be so broken. 5, 6. It can be a little more fluid, but slow. 9, 10. Awesome. Come back in. One more Pilates abs. Whew. Relaxed. We're going to do corkscrew. So open the toes, keep the heels together, and make a big circle on the ceiling. The feet stay straight up and you're drawing a circle clockwise. This is 7, 6, we're doing 10 each way. 5, 4, get as big as you can. 3, 2, and 1. Now reverse, left, counterclockwise, 2, 3, shoulders stay on the ground, the hips too. 6, 7, I feel it, 8, and 9, nice, and 10, beautiful, breathe. And then roll up onto your side, nice, good. Bring the knees up in line with your hip, reach down and around, grab your ankle. All right, keep this foot flat, the whole leg, and you're gonna pull. This is a quad stretch. You're kicking the foot away. Notice I don't have my heel on my butt. I'm kicking my foot to the wall. Then I come back in, run my nose to my knee, and extend. Do that 5 times. See how my bottom leg wants to roll up? Don't let it. Breathe. 2, 3. It's like Lord of the Dance, only you're laying. 4, 5, nice, good, extend. Now drop that bottom leg, that top leg, extend the bottom leg, and lift that inside leg for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. It's a really good knee protector, piriformis stretcher too. 1, hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Drop both legs, now roll your top shoulder back. Get a nice stretch. Do this. Release your back, your chest. Awesome, good. Come up and switch the other way. Great. Yeah, good. Yeah, so it's grab, bring your knees in line with your hips, reach down and around, grab the ankle. Just keep, you want to keep your leg parallel too to the ground. You don't want your knee up or down, perfect. And then come in, open. That's 1, breathe, swing, 2, feels good, 4, right there, I can feel it in my knee, 5, we'll end on that, bring this leg out, we'll extend that bottom leg and lift, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. When I'm skiing a lot, I'm finding my knees bothering me, I throw this little stretch in every night and it makes a huge difference. Or even in the morning, I start it. Nice. Let's come up. For 1 second, let's do a little bit of swimming, right? But get your feet up against the wall. We're going to do swimming, but we're also going to do plank against the wall just for 1 second, right? And it's just kind of fun to use the wall. So get your feet on a wall where you know you're not going to slide. It's hard to do. You got to like keep one foot on the ground until you can find your spot. Like for me right now, I haven't done it. I need to be a little higher. And just do that and hold. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now work on working your feet. Once you set that pattern, your body will learn. I just got my feet down a little bit lower. Nice. Yep, it's hard to to do. That's a good way to reverse challenge your body while walks. Okay? And then now just do this little stretch here, right? So shoulders over the hips, reach back, but don't compress back, arch. Get a good little nice stretch in your psoas. And lengthen the spine even though you feel like you're compressing. It's a good length in the lower back there. Awesome. One more, breathe. Bring your, you wanna try to get your shoulders over your ankles. Breathe. Nice. Back in a nice child pose. Drop your forehead to the ground. Right, your feet can be together, your knees can be together, they can be open, whatever you need. Take your left hand over your right and just roll your right shoulder down to the ground and you'll let your left hip, everything just rotate. Still keeping your butt back though. Switch, right? So I don't want you like this. I want your butt back. I want that reach, and then you can rotate like this and breathe. It's a good like stretch. Nice. Ooh. All right, one more body strength in our. So leg here, and you can have your arms right under your elbows, right under the shoulders. And I want you to lift the right leg. I don't want you to bend. I don't want you to just lift the bottom of the leg. I want that whole leg all the way up to the hip. And then I want you to lift the other side. You push that, even but keep the hip on the ground, then lift the leg. See the difference? You're gonna really push the hip bones into the ground. It works your core differently than this. Like that's good and that's strong, but what I want force. You'll feel the difference in the pelvis. Push your pelvis. Nice, good. Switch. Now walk it. Go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, push, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice. Now, I want you to do the upper body, right? I want you to keep your elbows here, and I want you to just lift enough that you just feel the weight shift to the elbow, only the elbow. Breathe. Squeeze that lower muscle, that thoracic muscle. Now you can add this. This is when you want to squeeze your shoulder blades together. Squeeze. Keep the feet on the ground. Keep the legs relaxed. It's hard. You're separating. Nice. Do 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now we'll do everything together and just hold. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then you can sway. Maintain the same up with your shoulders. Like don't have one more than the other. Beautiful. Nice. Whew. Wait, now reach around. Come up. Bring your left arm onto the ground. Bend your right leg. Right? And reach. Try to keep your shoulders level. Keep the equal weight on the quad. Now kick up to the sky. This is wheel. We want the arc to be equal, the upper and the lower body to be the same. So you want that, not that. Lift, and now switch. Maintaining that length, right? So it's the length of the forearm. That's what you want. You're gonna reach around, flex that back foot, get the foot to the ceiling. Now cook and lift, hook, kick and lift, no cooking. You might be cooking a little. Kick it up, it's your mobility. Lift, lengthen, breathe. If I try to do this without setting this up, I'm like, oh, I'm like this, right? I mean, I don't want to be like that. You want to be like this. You know, neck hooking. Little mix of stretch and strengthen. Namaste.